house in Budapest, my hidden treasure chest, golden grand piano, my beauty focused EOU. Ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. My acres of a land I've achieved. It may be hard for you to stop and believe, but for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Ooh, for you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you owe me, then all of this will go away. My many artifacts, the list goes on. If you just say the words, I'll up and run. Oh, to you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Oh, to you, ooh, ooh, I'd leave it all. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you owe me, then all of this will go. Why I should never make a change. Baby.
Right, so I'm a teacher of classics, RS and Latin. I've used Memrise to help my first years learn Latin language. They put vocabulary into Memrise. It'll help them, it reminds them every now and then. I've used Socrative in all of my classes because it's a very useful quiz making app, and Nearpod is a very nice interactive presentation medium.
So I teach French and Spanish, and we have been using iPads with our first and third year, so it's a really nice way to introduce the language. They do a lot of vocabulary tasks on language apps, including Vocab Express. They've got an app for that. They can access that in class, which allows them to do independent learning, differentiated learning. We also have a school-based student planner, which is really useful for the students and their organisation. We have our own teacher version. We're able to give set homework and set tasks and help encourage students to be more organised with their work, and it's really useful for them. They really like it because it comes all into one place. I've also started using Class Dojo with some of my more challenging classes because it's a really lovely reward system, and again you can use it on the PC, but because you also have access to it on your iPad, it's very instantaneous, and they can see their marks by using a reflector app. They can see it projected on the screen straight away, and that's a really encouraging way for them to stay focused and stay on task. And equally you can award negative sanctions and also positive sanctions, praise as well, which they really enjoy. And I've more recently started using Socrative as well for my older classes. It's a really good revision tool. Most of year 11s don't really enjoy learning vocabulary, but by sort of tricking them into doing it as a quiz, then it's a little bit more engaging for them.
I teach mathematics to students in the school from age 11 to 18, so quite a cross-section. Something I've used the IT for, particularly the iPads, is Socrative, which I'm finding a very useful diagnostic tool, in particular for gauging whether students have initially got a concept just after I've taught it. So I'll teach something, let them try a few questions, and then in that time that they are doing some questions, I will write a few quick questions on Socrative, and then set them off on the task, and then I can identify errors or misconceptions very quickly, and that's proved very useful.
Okay, my name is Mrs. Quinn, and I teach economics and business studies, and we teach on sixth form, where we have shared classes with two teachers. So since we've been taught how to use Google Classroom, it means that we've been able to set up a classroom and share resources between the two teachers that we can then invite the pupils to. And we found this a fantastic fantastic way to collaborate without actually having to even be in the same room.
Yes, so I've used various things, Google Classroom, various apps with some of the students. Used them, done film recording, done Poplet, done some online testing, also done a little bit with some of the Hour of Code stuff. Lots of flowcharty type stuff, yeah, odds and sods, really. Variety of different new bits of technology. Be good.
Hi, I'm a design technology teacher. I tried Beaboard for the first time with a Year 7 group. I teach a unit on food and health, and we talk about different food groups and what sort of food they've eaten in the last 24 hours. I got them all to enter up onto the screen, everything they've eaten in different food groups, and it worked really well. Some of them were a little bit silly, but most of it went very successfully. They liked the colours and they liked putting up pictures.
Hi, I'm a teacher of art, and in art we've been using Sketchbook Pro, which is a good stepping stone for Photoshop, and we also like Paper 53 as a form of sketchbooks. It's a good way of keeping all their work, but also allowing them to analyse their work as well. The Sketchbook Pro is great for bolstering confidence and also enforcing lessons that we've learnt in art with contour lines, tone, colour, etc. In extended studies, we work with the first years, and it allows us to be a little bit more creative. And we've done things like podcasting, using speaker DJ, and also audio boom. And this is great for giving the students a voice in the school. We've also encouraged them to use Touchcast, which is fabulous in getting them close to a TV scenario, and it allows multiple disciplines to come in, from videos to tweets to ticker tapes to images, and also themselves presenting work. GarageBand is super for creating music and also collaborative work, and gives them the opportunity to be a little bit more sort of hip and out there with their work.
And all this is new?
All this is new, and it's creating and leading to an awful lot of extra work, which is exciting, and the students can actually bring something that's really positive back into the classroom as well through their experiences.
So I teach English, and I've used quite a range of things, but I've used Notability to get the students to annotate text. I gave them a document via Google Classroom, and then they opened it and downloaded it onto Notability. They colour-coded lots of different quotes to sort them into different categories, and then they saved that in their Google Drive, so I could have a look at what they'd done.
Okay.
What's this then, Becky?
So this is my French poster comic, cool. As you can see. Third years, we're practicing the past tense, and they've created a story about a holiday on their iPads.
Yeah.
And then I've printed them so that they can make a nice display.
Great. So what app did you use?
Comic Life.
Comic Life, okay. And how did they find all their pictures?
Through the internet, I presume. Mm. I wasn't there. So
it was a homework.
So they've written some nice stories.
Yeah. And how did you get them to submit it to you?
They emailed to my Gmail account.
Uh-huh. And do they have to save that in a particular format, or can they just send it straight from their app?
I think some of them saved it as a picture, and then sent pictures, and some just sent straight through the app.
Good.
How about you?
Yeah.
What have you tried?
Well, I've tried a range of things, but one of the things that we've used quite a bit is some book creator, so some e-books. And so we're going on a trip to the Aachen Christmas Market today, as you know, coming. And so to get them to do a little bit of research about it, we set them some questions. So I set them the questions, really simple in German, and then they had to do a page on each of the questions, so do a bit of research on the internet, and then come up with their answers. So some pictures and some German as well. And for the vocabulary that they didn't know, I wanted them to use dictionaries, not Google Translate, which we hate. and they were quite good at that. And it was a question of me showing them then what dictionary to use, where it is, and how to use it. And they were not too bad, except for that one who wrote That sentence about ich bin funktionieren nach Frankfurt, which was cobbled together in a very poor way and meant nothing at all. But so they're going to finish those off after the weekend, and I'm hoping it should be quite interesting and we'll be able to put them on our website.
Are you able to see the ebooks?
I'm hoping so. I've asked them to send them in a particular format, which I'm hoping will come to me and work. And then I should be able to open them and we'll put them on the website. And people can see them.
Hello there, I'm head of Latin, head of classics. I've been using iPads with my first years, which is year 7, and they've been using them to access the website to the course that we do, the Cambridge Latin course. They've also been producing charts, grammar charts on Keynote, which is a much more reliable way of them keeping their grammar, and it's much clearer for them as well. On our website, the Classics website, I have uploaded a lot of student work, which has included stuff done on their iPad through iMovie, through PowerPoints, recording themselves taking films on school trips we've been on, also photographs of creative work which they've done. Also, a number of resources are online as well, which they have access to and they can click on if they go onto the website.
Now it's going, yeah.
This term, been using several iPad apps, been using Poplet for mind mapping, which has proved simple and effective. Also, the casting one.
Touchcast.
Touchcast, which shows promise for use across different areas and for teaching as a tool. Firefly has been quite good in terms of assessment and uploading student work. Google Drive is probably the best overall package of all the providers in terms of what it shows, and is a well-rounded package.
Okay. Hi, I'm Dave. I'm a DT teacher. Mine isn't particularly exciting, but it's a quite essential tool, I think. I've been using the Google Drive because we've got iPads in the school now, and the students clearly need to back up their work so far. There's a few smashed screens and things like that. So if they damage their iPads, we need to make sure they've got their design coursework and the work they're working on available for them. So using the Drive is really useful because we can set up shared folders, we can share that with the students can set up their own folders and share that with us. I've got instant access to their project work, I've got instant access to their e-portfolios that they're putting together, so I can mark them, add the feedback, they can see it, and it all kind of works really well.
Always?
Not always.